हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर डिस्कसिंग कंटिन्यूइंग अबाउट द चैप्टर सेट्स. इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी आर डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ सेट्स, कंसेप्ट ऑफ सेट्स, टाइप्स ऑफ सेट्स, एलिमेंट ऑफ अ सेट्स. नाउ इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द सबसेट, पावर सेट, यूनिवर्सल सेट, प्रॉपर सबसेट एंड अदर टाइप ऑफ सेट्स. सो नाउ वी स्टार्ट विद द कंसेप्ट ऑफ सबसेट. नाउ सो व्हाट इज सबसेट? लेट ए एंड बी आर टू गिवन सेट. देन सेट ए इज कॉल्ड subset of B if all the elements of set A are the elements of set B denoted by a subset of B. A and B are two given set. Then set A is said to be subset of set B if all the elements of set A are the element of set B. We only check that all the element of set A should be the element of set B, and the indication of denotation by A subset of B. For example, A equal to ABC and B equal to BCA. Here all the elements of set A are the element of set B. So this implies that A is the subset of B. Set written symbolically. If X belongs to A implies that X belongs to B, then A will be subset of B. Theoretically, if we want to check that, so we have only a condition: if X belongs to A and this implies that X belongs to B, then we can say A is the subset of B. Now, next term, proper subset. Let A and B are two given set, then A said to be proper subset of B if all the elements of set A are the elements of set B, but all the elements of set B are not the element of set A, denoted by A proper subset B. For example, A equal to ABC, B equal to ABCD. Here we are observing all the element of set A are the element of set B, but all the element of set B are not the element of set A. So in this condition, set A is called proper subset of B. So here A is the proper subset of B, and B is called superset of A. Now I am taking a new topic inside the sets, subsets of a set. First we discuss about the definition of subsets. If all the element of set A are the element of set B, then A is called subset of B. Now what are the subsets of any set? So let A equal to AB, this is a given set, then subset of A are phi. First subset is phi, other A, B and AB. These are the subsets of the set A, and in which each is the set. When the element written inside the curly bracket, then it is converted into the set. So these are the four subsets there when the element of the set A are A, B. If element of the set A are 1, 2, 3, then subsets of A are phi, bracket 1, bracket 2, bracket 3, 1, 2, 2, 3, 1, 3 and 1, 2, 3. So here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There are 8 subsets of a set A if the number of elements in set A are 3. So according to these examples, we are summarize some notes. Empty set phi, because each set have the subset phi. So each empty set phi is the subset of every set. So for if A is the given any set, so phi is the subset of A. Also B, also C, so phi is the subset of every set. Next, every set is the subset of itself. Whenever you write the set A, AB, so here the subset is AB. In second example, A equal to 1, 2, 3, the subset is also 1, 2, 3. So each subset, each set is the subset of itself. That is the second condition. Third, here we observe, there are two elements in set A. So the number of subsets are 1, 2, 3, 4 to the power 2. In this case, number of elements are 3, so we have the number of subsets 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, that means 2 to the power 3. So if number of elements in any set A are n, then number of subsets of A equal to 2 to the power n. So if the number of subsets are given, number of elements are given, then we can find how many subsets a given set has. Next definition, power set. Let A be a given set, then set of all subsets of a set A is called power set of set A. A be a given set, then collection of all subsets of a set A is called power set of set A, denoted by PA. So we know that well, if A equal to AB, so it's called power set of A, denoted by PA. Here subsets of AB are phi, A, B, AB. Now the collection of these elements can be written as, if A equal to AB, then power set of A is phi, A, B, AB. And these subsets written inside the bracket, that means this now become a set. So collection of all subsets of a set A is called the power set of A. Similarly, if A equal to 1, 2, 3 here, so power set is given by phi, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 2, 3, 1, 3 and 1, 2, 3. One thing observing here, all the elements of the power set are in the form of set. Because phi is the entry set, this is also set, this is also set, this is also set. So we know that well, according to this condition, all the elements of a power set are the sets. Now, if A equal to A, B, C, then power set of A is given by phi, A, B, C, A, B, B, C, A, C, A, B, C. So, if number of elements in set A are 3, and here number of elements in PA is given by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. But these are also the subset of set A. So if number of elements in set A are 3, then number of elements in power set of A are to the power 3, that means 8. So the number of subsets of any sets and the number of elements in a power set, the same quantity, having the same quantity. Now next topic is universal set. What is the concept of universal set? Normally in the questions we use the universal set by the symbol U, capital U. Suppose that we are taking these three sets at that time. A, B, C are three given sets. Then a set denoted by U, which is superset of A, B, C in this context. जिस समय आप कोई क्वेश्चन को सॉल्व कर रहे हैं उस समय कई सेट आप यूज कर रहे हैं, उन सेट के लिए अगर आपको एक ऐसा सेट मिल जाता है जो उन सबका सुपर सेट हो, थोड़ी देर पहले मैंने आपको सुपर सेट बताया था कि इफ ए इज द प्रॉपर सबसेट ऑफ बी देन बी इज कॉल्ड सुपर सेट ऑफ ए. तो एक ऐसा सेट जो बाकी सारे सेट्स के लिए उस समय सुपर सेट बन जाए इज कॉल्ड यूनिवर्सल सेट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू इक्वल टू ए बी सी डी ई, हियर A equal to ADE, B equal to ACD, B equal to BC, equal to BCD. You are observing there A, B, C, all the three sets are the subset of, are the proper subset of set U. This is the superset. So in this case, U is the universal set. And again, U equal to 1, 2, 3, A equal to 1, 3, B equal to 2, 3. So A and B both are the proper subset of U. Again, U is the universal set. This is the concept of universal set. According to Venn diagram, if we show here, I am given this Venn diagram for the example number 2. The universal set is 1, 2, 3. A is, so here A is, this is U, universal set. 2, 3, this is the set A, this is the set B. 3 is the common element, 1, 2, 3. This is the way of representation inside the universal set. So U is the universal set 1, 2, 3. Here A and B. A have the element 1, 3. B is the element 2, 3. So A, all the elements of U are given by 1, 2, 3. 1, 3 is the element of set A. 2, 3 are the element of set B. So this is the Venn diagram process represent the universal set. Now we will discuss about the most important topic, and this topics you can use till end of the mathematics from your last class of mathematics. आप इन topics का इस्तेमाल यहां से लेकर के जब तक आप mathematics पढ़ेंगे 11th, 12th, उसके बाद हायर एजुकेशन में चाहे आप बीटेक में जाए या किसी और उसमें जाते हैं मैथमेटिक्स पढ़ने के लिए, तो वहां इनका इस्तेमाल होगा. और अब आपको ध्यान रखना है कि ब्रैकेट्स के मायने क्या है, ब्रैकेट्स के मायने क्या है, ब्रेसेस सब अलग अलग किस प्रकार से शो करते हैं. इंटरवल एज द सबसेट ऑफ आर रियल नंबर्स, सेट ऑफ रियल नंबर्स. सो हियर द फर्स्ट इज क्लोज इंटरवल, द टॉपिक क्लोज इंटरवल. लेट आर बी द सेट ऑफ रियल नंबर्स एंड ए बी आर द रियल नंबर्स सच दैट ए लेस देन बी. Here we choose two real numbers A and B, where A is less than 2B. Then collection of all real numbers X, we give the name X, such that satisfying the condition A less than equal to X less than equal to B. ऐसे सारे real numbers जो A और B के बीच में आ सकते हैं, वो A भी हो सकते हैं, B भी हो सकते हैं, उनके बीच में भी आ सकते हैं. We know that well from the class 10. Between two real numbers, there are infinite numbers of real numbers can be inserted. They may be rational, they may be irrational. So between A and B, A and B are two real numbers, A less than 2B. So the collection of all real numbers X such that A less than equal to X less than equal to B is called closed interval, denoted by the brackets AB. This is the important brace there, AB. So now in set builder form, AB equal to X, that means X is the element of this interval. And what is the condition of this element? A less than equal to X less than equal to B, and as the values of X may be equal to X or greater than 2X, may be equal to B or less than equal to B, where A, B and X are the real numbers. जैसे मैं एक सेट लिखता हूं, एक सेट मैंने लिखा A equal to 1, 2, curly brackets लग के अंदर, that means only prior are there 1 and 2 only. But here if 1 and 2 are there, that means infinite number of real numbers are there including this interval. if we show close interval as per the real line, so here the number line is given there, minus infinite to infinite, we take two real values a and b, a is less than 2b. So now, because both the values are included there in interval, so we have dark bubble there and all the values between a and b are there including in this interval. Similarly, now open interval, let R be a set of real numbers, AB belongs to R, A less than 2B, same condition here, the collection of all X belongs to R, such that, now condition is changed now, A less than 2X, less than 2B, here A less than equal to X, less than equal to B, so only those elements, they are lying between A and B, called open interval, denoted by the brushes small a, small b, here inside vector form, AB equal to X, X satisfying the condition A less than X less than B, so AB X belongs to R here. If we so on the number line, so this is the number line here, minus infinite to infinite, we show the number A and B, and B is the simple bubble without filling. That means border values are not included there. Border values are not included there. So between only the elements between A and B are lying. Are the element of this interval. Now next, I am written the sort, semi-open interval. Semi-open means an interval which is open from beginning but end, but grows in end. So semi-open interval means AB. So here definition is X, where A less than X but less than equal to B, where ABC, X, B are the element of R. Here A is the without dark and B is the dark, because A is not included, B is included. Similarly, semi-close means close from beginning but open from end. So these are the intervals as the subset of real numbers.